And welcome to this lecture. And in this lecture, we are going to design the new activity, which is this new activity, which is going to be a success activity, which we want to display once the user is logged in into our system. So what we'll do is that we'll just quickly go ahead, create a new activity. That's going to be an empty activity and it's going to be named as new activity. And click finish and the new activity is going to be created for you. So now in this activity, what we want to do is that you want to go to the XML code of this, take a plain text view, place it at the center, and let's name this thing as something like, let's say success. That means we are successfully redirected to this activity, which means that we are now logged in. So once this thing is done, we are good to go. Now the next thing which you need to do is that you also need to add a functionality for logging out the user from here. So what we will do is that we will go to the Java code of this, and the first thing which we do is that we get a reference to the Firebase auth over here as well. So private Firebase auth and mauth, and after this let's also get the auth state listener. So private Firebase auth dot auth state listener, that's going to be auth state listener. And here what we do is that we will create a button over here which is going to be called as a logout. So let me just quickly go ahead in the text view and add up a button over here. So we'll type in button, that's going to be wrap content and wrap content, and let's say the button is going to be having a text which says logout. And the on click of this is going to be, let's say, sign out. So once this thing is done, we are good to go. And let me just reposition this button over here and we are good to go. And let's go to the Java code and quickly write in the sign out method. So that's going to be public void sign out. That's going to have a view. And here what we do is that we get mauth over here equals Firebase auth dot get instance. So we get the instance for the Firebase authentication. Then a simple thing which you need to do is that you simply need to type in mauth dot sign out, and that's going to sign out your user. Now once the user is signed out, what you want to do is that you want to redirect him to the first activity, that is the login activity again. So we'll type in start activity and create a new intent inside this itself. So this is going to be new intent, and this is going to be new activity dot this comma, and the activity where you want to redirect this user is going to be the main activity dot class. So once this thing is done, we are basically good to go, and hopefully everything should be working now. So let me just go ahead, save the code, and we'll try to run this application and see if it has any errors. So if we have any errors, then we'll make sure to go ahead and resolve them. Let's run this application on the device and see how it works. So as you could see, the application is up and running, and what we will do is that we will purposely put up a wrong email ID over here. So that's going to be abc.mwp.com or something like that. Or let's say avd@abc.com, and let's put in some random password. And when we hit login, it says incorrect username or password. And when we left some field as blank, it says enter both values. So these two things are working fine. And now let's see what happens if we enter some correct values. So abc@xyz.com was the real email, and the password was admin123. So when I hit login, as you could see, we are successfully redirected to the new activity. That means we have successfully implemented the login application. So when I click logout, as you could see, we are again logged out of the application. And when I click login, as you could see, it says enter both values. So that means we have successfully set up the authentication for our Firebase application. So that's it for this lecture, and I hope you guys were able to understand how to set up authentication for Firebase. And actually it's quite simple to do as compared to other techniques which you could use for authentication. So what you simply need to do here in the Firebase authentication is that you do need to get a reference to the mAuth, to the Firebase authentication, just as you get a reference for the database. And then what you need to do is that you need to implement a few inbuilt methods, which is this method right here, which basically allows you to check if the entered values are correct. So this sign in with email and password is an inbuilt method wherein you only have to pass the email and password values, and Firebase is going to take care of the rest. And for signing out as well, you simply need to execute the sign out method. Once you do that, everything is taken care of by Firebase and you don't have to worry about anything. So that's it for this lecture, and I'll see you guys in the next one.